This video demonstrates the basics of the DevExpress localization service, a website that allows developers to translate DevExpress UI into different languages and share their translations with the entire developer community. First, the video shows how you can use the website to specify translations for DevExpress UI elements. After you specified all necessary translations, you can download localization assemblies that you will later use in your projects. The video will then show you how to apply the generated translations to projects that target different platforms, WinForms, WPF, ASP.NET WebForms or MVC, and finally, Blazor. To access the localization service, go to devexpress.com and select Support, then Localization. The website will ask you to log in with your DevExpress account if you haven't done so already. If this is the first time you use the service, you'll see an empty list. To get started, click Add a Translation. Let's leave the latest version selected and pick Italian from the language list. The translation column indicates that over 85% of all strings already have translations assigned. Note that only translations to German, Japanese, Spanish, and Russian are officially supported by DevExpress. The rest, including Italian, are based on our algorithm that accepts translations suggested and used by other developers. We recommend that you double-check that all translations are acceptable. Let's change some of the string translations. Click Modify. In the search box, type Drag a Column Header. This query will locate the text that our grid controls display in the group panel. If the search doesn't return any results, review the filter controls. In this case, the specified strings already have translations, so change the display selection from Not Translated to All. Now you'll see four strings used in our different grid controls: ASP.NET, Blazor, WinForms, and WPF. If you need, you can filter strings by platform. See the .NET platform combo box above the list. Let's use Bing Translator to shorten the message. I'll use only the first few words. Drag a column here. Copy the translated string and switch back to the DevExpress localization service. Replace the translations for all platforms. When you're done, click Save and then Download. The service informs you that it will send the link to compiled assemblies in an email to your registered address. Return to the translation list. As you can see, you can always come back and download the assemblies you require. Make sure that you check the boxes in the last column. Once you receive the email from the DevExpress localization service, go ahead and click the link to download the archive. Extract the contents. Once the extraction is complete, you can review the list of included assemblies. You'll need different files for different platforms, and this video will guide you through the basics. You can also refer to DevExpress documentation for additional information. The email contains links to instructions for WinForms, WPF, ASP.NET, and Blazor developers. The very last link leads you to an overview help topic for the localization service. From there, you can navigate to articles on how to localize cross-platform libraries and frameworks such as reporting, dashboard, and XAF. Let's use a simple project with a grid control on a form to illustrate how localization assemblies work. Run the application to preview the app and to see that the group panel text and context menu commands are all in English. In Visual Studio, right-click the project folder and open it in Windows Explorer. Navigate to Bin, then Debug, and you'll see four folders with localized resources: German, Spanish, Japanese, and Russian. DevExpress controls automatically add these resources so you can use them without any extra steps. You can navigate into one of the folders to see the assemblies required by the current application. You'll notice that one says Extra Grid. This is the DLL that holds UI string translations for the DevExpress WinForms grid. Return to Visual Studio and apply one of these existing translations. In program.cs, write a line of code that explicitly sets the current culture to German, and run the application. As expected, the group panel text is now in German. So are context menu commands. Now let's apply the Italian translation we created in the beginning of this video. Open the project folder again. In another Windows Explorer window, locate the downloaded Italian resources. Navigate to the project's debug folder and create a new directory named IT for Italian. Find the extra grid assembly in the downloaded resources and copy it to the newly created folder. Change the code that specifies the current culture and run the application. As you can see, the group panel now uses the shortened version of the text we specified. Context menu commands, as well as other UI elements, are all in Italian. Let's again use a simple project with a grid control on a form. Run the application to preview the app and to see that the group panel text and context menu commands are all in English. In Visual Studio, right-click the project folder and open it in Windows Explorer. Navigate to Bin, then Debug, and you'll see four folders with localized resources: German, Spanish, Japanese, and Russian. DevExpress controls automatically add these resources so you can use them without any extra steps. You can navigate into one of the folders to see the assemblies required by the current application. You'll notice one that says xpf.grid. That is the DLL that holds UI string translations for the DevExpress WPF data grid. Return to Visual Studio and apply one of these existing translations. In app.xaml code behind, add a handler for the startup event. In the handler, write a line of code that explicitly sets the current culture to German. And run the application. As expected, the group panel text is now in German. So are context menu commands. Now let's apply the Italian translation we created in the beginning of this video. Open the project folder again, and in another Windows Explorer window, locate the downloaded Italian resources. In the project's debug folder, create a new directory named IT for Italian. Find the xpf.grid assembly in the downloaded resources and copy it to the newly created folder. Change the code that specifies the current culture and run the application. As you can see, the group panel now uses the shortened version of the text we specified. Context menu commands, as well as other UI elements, are all in Italian. To demonstrate how localization works in WebForms and MVC projects, let's use the DevExpress responsive application template. Run the application to preview the app and to see that the text in the group panel and pager is all in English. In Visual Studio, right-click the project folder and open it in Windows Explorer. Navigate to the Bin directory and you'll see four folders with localized resources: German, Spanish, Japanese, and Russian. DevExpress controls automatically add these resources so you can apply them without any extra steps. You can navigate into one of the folders to see the assemblies required by the current application. The grid views resources are in the common devexpress.web file. Return to Visual Studio and apply one of these existing translations. In web.config, locate the globalization option and set the culture to German. Run the application. As expected, the group panel text and pager text are now in German. Now let's apply the Italian translation we created in the beginning of this video. Open the project folder again. In the project's bin folder, create a new directory named IT for Italian. In another Windows Explorer window, locate the downloaded Italian resources. Find the devexpress.web assembly in the list and copy it to the newly created folder. Change the code that specifies the current culture and run the application. As you can see, the group panel now uses the shortened version of the text we specified. Pager text, as well as other UI elements, are all in Italian. To demonstrate how localization works in Blazor projects, let's use a basic Blazor server project with a DevExpress data grid on a page. Run the application to preview the app and to see that the text in the group panel and command column is all in English. In Visual Studio, select Tools, then NuGet Package Manager. Open the Manager UI for the current solution. Search for Blazor in your personal DevExpress NuGet feed. You'll see four packages with localized resources: German, Spanish, Japanese, and Russian. DevExpress ships these packages so you can apply the corresponding translations with the minimum possible steps. Let's install the German translation package. Once installed, the corresponding dependency appears in the Solution Explorer. In startup.cs, locate the configure method and add a few lines of code. You'll need to create a list of supported cultures, then initialize an object with localization options, and finally use that object to localize the UI. And run the application. As expected, the group panel text and command in the first column are now in German. Now let's apply the Italian translation we created in the beginning of this video. Open the project folder in Windows Explorer. Navigate to Bin, Debug, then Netcore App 3.1. You'll see a folder named DE. Review its content to see the assembly that contains translations for all DevExpress Blazor controls. Create one more localization directory and change its name to IT for Italian. In another Windows Explorer window, locate the downloaded Italian resources. Find the DevExpress.Blazor assembly in the list and copy it to the newly created folder. Change the code that specifies the current culture and run the application. As you can see, the group panel now uses the shortened version of the text we specified. Command column text, as well as other UI elements, are all in Italian. And that's it for this video. If you liked this video, please give us a thumbs up. If you have questions, please comment below. Please remember to subscribe to this channel and ring the bell to get notifications for more great DevExpress training videos. Thanks for watching, and thank you for choosing DevExpress.